We have somewhere, I asked the staff to write it down for me, and they did, not for this, but for a longer discussion. We have somewhere, in terms of infrastructure, we rank 13th globally in infrastructure.
Ooh, sometimes when someone's just reading off note cards, it makes people wonder, why does he have to read off note cards? But before we get to some advice on this, let's take a look at a clip of Joe answering a question on North Korea.
Let me say that, number one, UN Resolution 1718 was violated by those particular missiles that were tested. Number one, we're consulting with our allies and partners, and there will be responses if they choose to escalate. We will respond accordingly. But I'm also prepared for some form of diplomacy, but it has to be conditioned upon the end result of denuclearization.
So guys, Joe read the entire answer from a note card, and powerfully so, I might add. But next time, you might want to have Joe not read off note cards for a couple reasons. One, having the exact answer to a reporter's question pre-written kind of makes it look like you knew the questions beforehand. So it kind of looked as if you pre-wrote questions, gave them to friendly reporters, to ask Biden, and then Biden read pre-written answers from note cards. And that kind of makes the whole press conference look more like a theatrical performance than an actual press conference. You know, people don't like deception. Ooh, and it also makes people aware that he's not speaking his own thoughts from his own mind.
I'll be happy to take your questions. Zeke, Associated Press. Justin Sink, Bloomberg. Where am I here? Let me see. Caitlin? Okay, hang on a second here. Kristen, Nancy, CBS? Ken? Yeah, Kristen? Let me get here. Okay, Cecilia, Vega. Okay, hang on. Sorry. Oh, Sing Min, Miss Kim. How about Yamish?
That kind of makes it look like he's looking for who you instructed him to call on in his notebook. So I'd probably get rid of the notebook because people know what it's being used for.
Thank you all. Thank you all for listening. Okay.
Joe.
Operations. Okay, get ready for this one. Will you stand with Joe Biden?
And Secretary Cardona and Mayor Bowser and Chancellor Fairbanks. You know, thank you for joining us as well.
And so the whole point of this is that we can do a lot to deal with endangered species.
I'm not going to speak out against what he's doing in Hong Kong, what he's doing with the Uyghurs in western mountains of China, and Taiwan trying to end the one China policy by making it forceful. He gets it. Culturally, there are different norms at each country, and their leaders are expected to follow.
This is unacceptable!
Well, just to break it to you, the culture of good people doesn't approve of just accepting genocide as a way of being more inclusive to the culture of mass murderers.
Folks, I learned something early on from my family and my mom and dad. They said, Joey, nobody is better than you, but everyone is your equal. Everyone is your equal. And folks,
how are your meetings going in Cornwall, Mr. President? How are your meetings going here in Cornwall?
Very well.
Come on.
Joe loves Joe. She must like you.
I'm crazy about that.
This is like you guys. Mr. Right. President, no, I'm sorry. Harry Diamond from CNN. How are you?
He said that we're virtually turned,
and climate change was here. You know, the looks like a tornado. They don't call them that anymore. That hit the crops and wetlands in the middle of the country, and in Iowa and Nevada, and I mean it's just across the board. And
Mr. President, I got a question.
Yep.
Is the sun going to come out tomorrow?
And so, folks, this summer alone, communities with over 100 million Americans, 100 American Americans call home. And your Congresswoman, is this your district?
Grace Meng.
Oh, it's Grace's district.
No, it's Ocasio Cortez.
This is the Afghan stuck in third country.
What will happen to them? Provide 2 years of free university high-quality pre-K and high-quality pre-K 2 years that are...
Get the hell out of here. Get them out of here.
For time has come to wake and run and not give way to fear.
Visit vaccines.gov, vaccines.gov, or text your zip code to 438829.
6 years ago today, Hunter lost his dad and I lost my son.
And we're at the G7 and again today, the closed meeting. But I want to, this is, since the, back then, also trade representative, ambassador. And one of the things that, Europe is our natural partner. I'm leaving out a lot of people here. I apologize. I'm going to get in trouble. But anyway, we'll get back to that. But there's a lot that is happening. I used to always. There's a stanza from a poem of an Irish poet who we just lost. He said, "To deal with these changes, is that to have, and the economy collapsed. I think we sometimes forget that, and so I think we have a lot to deal with from to whether or not we're in a position that we can."
But the bottom line is, the other piece is, I'm going to try to change, and I've laid it out. I'll send you a copy of my plan, so you have it to
lift
see
every
it.
Voice?
Pardon me?
What, deliver every voice, or what?
No, the one that the plan I have is my manifesto for Black America.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the nation's Constitution Center. We have the great privilege of being a guest leader of this outfit for a year. It's an appropriate place to make the speech I'm about to make.
I'm gay.
Look, I like Bill Gates. The part I focused on in his book, he said Biden's a man of great integrity. I think he's a man of integrity as well. Look, the fundamental problem here is Bob Gates and I have disagreed.
Have zero emissions, net emissions by 2050. By 2020, make sure all our electricity is zero emissions.
Don't jump!
Thank you, sir.
You're fracking now! You're a gas fracker! Now you're full fracking!
which is an awesome rooftop garden. They exist on our rooftop, but you're not going to be able to see it from here. But if they want to give a wave,
I see them.
Yeah.
And we also have solar.
Jump.
We need you.
And then if I could just.
President, look at that nice kid with the American flag.
Don't jump!
Are you joking? Is this a joke?
Those walls were awful thin. I wonder how the hell my parents did it, but that's a different story.
Well, with these two folks that you're about to meet, if you haven't already, there's no doubt about them staying oiled and lubricated here. He's one crazy son of a gun.
Successful dump.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
Anybody wants to help me unload?
Now, for you who are not full Irish in this room, lubricating has a different meaning for us all. The president has a big stick. You all think I'm kidding. I'm not kidding.
And thanks for joining me. I'm here. The FEMA director is on. FEMA director Chris Wells, she's on, and I'm here with my senior advisor and boy who knows Louisiana very, very well, man. And New Orleans and Cedric Richmond.
Do I do it now, Bishop? You want me on now?
Yes.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
So would you like to say a couple words?
Am I supposed to speak now, or is Karen supposed to speak? I don't know. I don't want to get in trouble here. Well, it's me. Okay.
Let me ask you about
I'm having trouble
though,
hearing you. Can they turn up the volume a little bit said for me? Because I'm having trouble hearing you. I do apologize.
Honey, this hair is like 2 months into COVID, and it is doing its own thing, and it has its own mind.
Well, I actually hope this...
All this time, I'm looking at you, and I'm supposed to be looking at the camera.
In southeastern Pennsylvania.
I'm confused who I'm talking to here. But anyway, whoever it is, if you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black.
And I ask that you join me now in a moment of silence for all those in uniform and out of uniform. Military and civilian, who've given the last full measure of devotion. Thank you.
Sergeant Nicole G, who was one of the two female Marines who were killed among the 13, she was the one who posted that Instagram post holding the baby saying, I love my job, just a few days ago.
Only one!
And if there are American forces, if there's American citizens left, we're going to stay till we get them all out.
Now we believe that about 100 to 200 Americans remain in Afghanistan, with some intention to leave. The bottom line, 90% of Americans in Afghanistan who wanted to leave were able to leave. The governor asking me to come on down to visit and to see what visit.
My mind's going blank now. What's the song that is played where everybody is on the chair? Everybody, what I can't remember it. Anyway, it was, I remember spending time at the Tree of Life synagogues. She called me, said, Dad, when are you going? What are you spending time talking to the governor of New York? Why aren't you not in Louisiana? So y'all got to write a note for me that I'm down, all right? But I know still, there's work to do, and
in this area, and we've instructed my team to have all hands on deck to make sure that that happens, that we have and we're going to make this up.
About a constitutional amendment to ban gay marriage.
You know, think about this. The world's going to Hades in a handbasket, and we're going to debate the next 3 weeks, I'm told, gay marriage and God only knows what else. I can't believe the American people can't see through this. We already have a law, the Defense of Marriage Act, where we've all voted, not where I voted and others said, look, marriage is between a man and a woman, and states must respect that.
I'm going to be a bit repetitive. The eight-hour day, the weekend, you know, time and a half for overtime, safety standards, sick days, victories for all of us. Because I might add, you know, I notice when you all do that, everybody benefits, whether they belong to a union or not. Where they belong to a union or not.
Ocean, the National Oceanic, about $50 billion the idea these folks are running into anyway is going to build this year. We're going to provide retention incentives that's going to ensure federal wildland fires. This will include launching a new app on, you know, and.